I received this question the other day. Can you please help me find a formula to solve this problem? I've been looking on YouTube but haven't seen anything. Kind of requesting you, if you know the formulas, to please help me. Well, this is what the problem that he was having. So they were trying to figure out the days of operation or how long they've had this piece of equipment. And so what they were doing is basically they're putting in the start date, and then and it's basically a good formula. So it says equals today minus B3, which is the start date of this piece of equipment. Now this works fine when you have dates in there, but if you haven't started the operation of this piece of equipment, then you get a long date because it assumes that it's beginning of time, and so it gives you a long thing in here. So what you need to do is you need to test to see whether there actually is a date in here. Now, from my VBA world, there is a statement called is date, but we're trying to do this on a worksheet. So what a date normally works out to be is it's a number. And so what I've done here to fix this situation is I'm using the function is number. So I go, so what I do is I put a if statement in front of the today. So I go if, and I put an opening bracket, and then I use the is number function, and then I put another bracket here, and I test that if this one here, so if this value is a number, then, and then a comma, then I have the today equals today minus B2, and then I put a comma here, and then double quotation marks, so that if it's not a number, just leave it blank, and then closing brackets, and that will clean up all the errors that we have in these formulas. So that's how you test for a number in a cell to complete a formula. Please subscribe.